What is included in the financial statement? There are so many items are in the trial balance, and there are three parts of financial statement: trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Today I'll show you what to write in the first section of an income statement, which is trading account. Hello students, I'm Ashiqul Rahman. Welcome back to my channel. So let's get started. So look at here. This is the layout, the format of an income statement. The first section of income statement. What is that? That is income statement, and in the bracket you should write trading account. Okay, so look at here. In this section, in this account, first of all, you have to write the sales revenue. This item will be given in the credit side of your trial balance. So take this sales item and put it here. First of all, in this here, you might have noticed 1, 2, 3 dollar columns side by side. These columns are there just to facilitate your calculation. Okay, so that you can calculate everything smoothly, properly, so that you understand how this gross profit will be generated. Okay, so look at here. So first of all, we wrote here sales revenue. The value will be here in the middle column. Okay, not even here, in the middle column, sales revenue. Okay, then what should you write? You should write sales return. This will be given in the trial balance as well. Okay, sometime it will be given, sometime it will not be given. No matter, if you have in the trial balance, you take it and you subtract the sales return from your sales revenue. Okay, put this value under this sales revenue, and this bracket means you have to subtract. Then you write the answer in the outer column. Okay, last column. After that, you should write cost of sales. Okay, cost of sales. So what is belongs to cost of sales? First one is opening inventory. This opening inventory will be included in the trial balance. So most of the time you will get this inventory in the trial balance. Sometimes it is not be given, but so take this opening inventory and write here that this value here in the middle column. Okay, the middle column. After that, you have to write the purchase. This purchase is a common item in the trial balance. It will be given, it's a must. So take this item purchase from the trial balance and write in the first column. Okay, after that you will have purchase return in the trial balance. Okay, take this purchase return and write it below purchase. So same way over here, you subtract your sales return from your sales revenue. Same way you will subtract your purchase return from purchase. Okay, so we'll write this value under this purchase, so that we can calculate properly. So now this is bracket, I told you. So you subtract it and you put this value here. After that, which item you have to write? Goods for own use. This goods for own use, often it will be written in the adjustments. Okay, not in the trial balance, in the adjustment it will be written goods for own use. If you have this adjustment, you have to subtract it from purchase. If you don't have, you don't need to write. Okay, so goods for own use, it means it's a drawing. Okay, owners to goods for his own use. So take this value and put under this answer here. Okay, then again you subtract this value from here, you write the answer here. Okay, then what to do? Then look at here, we added carriage inwards. Okay, carriage inwards, these items will be given in the trial balance. So if you have this item in the trial balance, don't think much, just take it out from there and put it here, okay, and just add this. So see over here, I did not put any bracket. It means that we have to add this value with this, okay. So add this and write the answer outer column here. Look, we wrote the answer here, not here, because we have nothing to calculate with purchase. Everything we wrote with purchase, whatever items we have with purchase to calculate, already we have written here, okay. So we have nothing to write, that's why we have to write this answer here. So once again, write purchase here in the first column, subtract your purchase return, subtract your goods for own use, then you add carriage inwards. Whatever answer comes, put it in the middle column, okay. So look at middle column, already we have opening inventory here in the middle column, okay. Now you got one more answer here, this answer. So this and this, these two items, these two amounts will be added. Then you have to write this answer here, okay. So you added opening inventory and you added the final answer of your purchase after all calculations. Then get the answer and put it here, okay. Very good. After that, you have to subtract the closing inventory, okay. Closing inventory will not be given with the trial balance, okay. This is not an item for trial balance. This item will be given apart from trial balance in the adjustment, okay. If you see that you have closing inventory in the question, don't think, just take it and write below this answer after adding opening inventory and purchase. Then whatever you have answer, okay, after subtraction, you got this answer. This answer is called cost of sales. How did you calculate this cost of sales? You calculate cost of sales like this: opening inventory plus purchase minus purchase return minus cost of goods for own use plus carriage inwards minus closing inventory equal to cost of sales, okay. We have sales revenue, okay. We have here already sales revenue in the final column, in the last column. Now one more item we got here, which is cost of sales, okay. So how to calculate gross profit? Sales revenue, sales minus cost of sales equal to gross profit or gross loss, okay. If your cost of sales is larger than sales, it will be gross loss. If your sales amount is larger than cost of sales, then you will have gross profit, okay. Now sales revenue minus cost of sales, look at here, we put minus here. Cost of sales, sales revenue minus cost of sales equal to gross profit or loss. Gross profit or loss. If you see that this item is larger than this item, you will have gross profit. If you see that this item is larger than this, then you will have gross loss, okay. It's very easy. This is how you have to prepare the first section of income statement, which is trading account, okay. And this is universal format, okay. Wherever you are studying, if you have accounting, you have to know income statement, okay. And the first part of income statement, you need to do like this way. If you remember these items, if you remember this chart, this layout, how I represented here, then you will have no problem. Whatever question, whatever trial balance is given, whatever items are given, you will be able to prepare this income statement, okay. So this is very important question, and it comes often in exam. So please learn it properly. And still, if you have any question, then please comment below. Let me know what you want to see in my next video. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoy it and you learned something. See you soon again. Subscribe my channel, hit the like button and share with your friends. I have another video on this topic, income statement, which is a profit and loss account section. I will post it very soon. So that's all. Bye and take care.